And welcome back, guys. We're going to be playing some more Wizards 101 here. Make sure you hit the like button. Make sure you subscribe button. Guess what I woke up to this morning? I woke up to no heat. My furnace decided to turn itself off sometime around midnight last night. And I'm like, okay, what the heck? It's really cold. The floor feels like I'm stepping on ice. Walk downstairs. Little lights on. Press the button. Hey, what's going to happen, right? Probably shouldn't have pushed the button, but I pushed it anyways. Okay, furnace turns back on. Alright, we got heating downstairs, but there's still no heat upstairs. So, that's what I've been dealing with all day, trying to get heating work upstairs. I finally gave up trying to get heating working upstairs and just turn on a portable heater. So, let's get into playing some Wizards 101. I'm gonna go play a little bit. And we'll see how many pieces of video content I'm able to produce for you tonight here. Anyways, let's get into it.
Krakotep ensured only the worthy could enter the inner sanctum. If you dare, step onto the teleporter at my right to try the test of strength. See if you can defeat the Son of Storms. We value intelligence as well as strength. Think you're clever enough? Then step onto the teleporter at my left and try the test of aptitude.
Those things that live must shine bright. Those things that do not live must remain dark. Night the moon shines bright, and the sun sleeps till dawn. The lighting in here isn't quite right for a storm. Much better. The words on the page are clearly readable. The sun shines down on the tree. Tree shades the snake. The snake hisses at the beetle. The beetle runs away. Much better. The sun shines down on the tree. Tree shades the snake hisses at the beetle. The beetle runs away.
Very well. You have passed both the test of strength and the test of aptitude. Prepare to enter the inner sanctum at once.
I'll never fall into your foul hands. Prepare to be vanquished.
Thank you.
Means nothing, young wizard. You shall never possess the croc. I sealed the Crocinomicon in the sarcophagus of the souls long ago. When the Dark One woke me, imagine his much like...
Crocopatra's laughter echoes in the empty chamber until silence reigns at last.
Amazing. By defeating her, you have done very well. I'm sorry you did not find the Crocinomicon, but when you... The strangers here fought bravely against the Tut army and should know you have ended the threat. Return to the surface and report your success.
there! Abner K. Doodle, your full disclosure. Can't simply put? Okay, I'm the point. All right, you may have noticed a new button on your screen. That opens up your cantrips menu. When you press that button, you'll notice the teleport to Buttersfield cantrip I just gave. I just realized the only cantrip Hampshire taught me, and the one he asked me to give out, is the one that teleports you directly to him. Since he'll be your primary cantrips instructor and vendor, that's just smart marketing. So go on, use the teleport to Buttersfield cantrip now.
So, you've defeated the mighty Crocopatra, have you? You're fast becoming the stuff of legend, young wizard. Without a leader, the Tuts should be easy to manage now. As much as you help me, I must seem pretty ungrateful. Here's what I can do. It's something inside the sarcophagus of the souls you're looking for, eh? A book, right? Take this Marylebone spiral key and go through the spiral door to Marylebone. Private Kinchley will help you find that book you're after. Wizard, I've an issue that requires... The Queen commissioned an expeditionary force led by The last letter we received stated the expedition chartered a trade ship to bring them here after a stop in Kimbal. The trade ship arrived on schedule. Our hands are full here, and I can't spare a single soul. Can you go to Kimbaloon to search for Beagle and his expeditionary force?
Thank you.
Come closer, so that I may crush you.
So I got a couple decisions here to make. I could either come back and do this later when I'm higher level. This one quest I just died in. I believe it's this one right here. I could do that. Or, you know what? I'm at full health. I'm going to try one more time. Thing is, I wasn't at full health, so. Turn that music back on. So I'm gonna go for the boss first. And then I'll go for his minion. Oh wow, it's just the boss, alright. Way easier. Thank you.
Excellent work. The Cyclops should now be easier to handle with their leader out of the picture.
I really don't like Mario Born. It's just the way layout where you can get easily snagged into stuff. That's what I don't like about it. That's why I'm trying to avoid going there until I have to type thing. No, it's a terrible thing to say. I'm looking for looking forward to going to Mushu, but I just really not that eager going to Marley Bone. So I'll probably do Soul Keeper later on, once I've leveled up a little bit. I still gotta go Copy Toby, the Bone Keeper's Crypt. So yeah, mostly I'm going to be trying to get these side quests killed off so it's, you know, more organized. You know, you don't have all these extra quests all over the place. It's like, meh. Anyways, make sure you hit that like button. Make sure to subscribe button. I'll see you guys in the next video.